Hello everyone, welcome in my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Devara, Assistant Professor in Geology, Government Dewan College, Bikaner. In the series of e-lectures of process of ore formation, we have earlier discussed the magmatic concentration process in which we have go through the early magmatic process of ore deposit. Today we are going to discuss late magmatic process. Late magmatic process formed toward close of magmatic period. It contains ore minerals which have crystallized at rather low temperature from residual magma. The magma which is left after crystallization of early formed rock silicates is called as residual magma, and this residual magma is rich in ore minerals. The late magmatic process is associated with mafic igneous rocks and deposits mostly iron or mostly ores of iron and titanium. Late magmeic prakram. Magmeic crystallin mein silicate khanijon ya shalekari khanijon ki nirman ki uparant avshisht drav se लेट मैग्मीय निक्षेपों का निर्माण होता है। यह प्रक्रम पूर्व मैग्मीय प्रक्रम से इस रूप में भिन्न है कि इसमें निक्षेपों का निर्माण करने वाले खनिज सिलिकेट खनिजों के क्रिस्टलन के उपरांत ही क्रिस्टलित होते हैं। ये निक्षेप वितलीय अथवा अधिवितलीय अल्प सिलिक सेलों के साथ शरीर में पाए जाते हैं। मैग्मीय सांद्रण प्रक्रम से निर्मित अधिकांश निक्षेप इस वर्ग के अंतर्गत आते हैं। इस वर्ग में निक्षेपों का निर्माण चार प्रमुख प्रक्रमों द्वारा होता है। Magmatic process in which the late magmatic process is divided into four types: residual liquid segregation, residual liquid injection, immiscible liquid segregation, and immiscible liquid injection. First, we discuss the residual liquid segregation. Avshisht drav prathakaran. The basic magma undergoes differentiation. May sometimes become enriched in iron and titanium. This heavy residual liquid may segregate and crystallize within the parent igneous mass, and such ore bodies commonly occur in form of parallel bands. The host rock are usually anorthosite, norite, gabbro, etc. And titaniferous magnetite bands of Busfeld igneous complex of South Africa are the best example of residual liquid segregation. Magma के विभेदन से अवशिष्ट मैग्मा में साधारणतः सिलिका सारीय पदार्थ एवं जल शेष रहते हैं, परंतु अल्प सिलिक मैग्मा जो एनोर्थाइट का निर्माण करता है विभेदन के उपरांत लोहे एवं टाइटेनियम को अवशिष्ट द्रव के रूप में बचाता है। यह अवशिष्ट द्रव शेष मैग्मा से पृथक होकर अयस्क निक्षेप के रूप में क्रिस्टलित होता है। अवशिष्ट द्रव पृथक्करण निक्षेप के निर्माण में क्रिस्टलन के दौरान पृथ्वी के उस भाग में विक्षोभों के या आंतरिक हलचलों से मुक्त होना पहली आवश्यकता है। इस वर्ग के निक्षेपों में अयस्क की मात्रा, मैग्मा की मात्रा एवं उसमें पाए जाने वाले खनिजकारी पदार्थ के प्रभावी प्रतिशत पर निर्भर करता है। So, this is the residual liquid segregate deposit. Also, the titaniferous magnetite deposit of Assam, Karnataka, and vanadiferous magnetite deposit of Mayurbhanj, Odisha are the Indian example of residual liquid segregation. Second one is the residual liquid injection, avshisht drava antakshepan. In this case, the residual liquid is squeezed out towards places of less pressure into the neighboring rock mass, forming late magmatic injection. Titaniferous magnetite deposits of Edinburgh Dike region of New York and magnetite dikes of Kasipatnam, Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh are the example of residual liquid injection. In this, the early magmatic deposits get segregated and this residual liquid injected into the adjacent rock and form the residual liquid injection. अवशिष्ट द्रव पृथक्करण प्रक्रम में शेष बचे लोह द्रव का स्थानीय शैल अथवा मात्र शैल मदर रॉक में अंतःक्षेपण होने से अवशिष्ट द्रव अंतःक्षेपण निक्षेपों का निर्माण होता है. इन निक्षेपों के निर्माण में अर्थ डिस्टर्बेंस या भूविक्षेपों का महत्वपूर्ण योगदान रहता है. अवशिष्ट द्रव भूविक्षेपों के कारण कम दाब वाले क्षेत्रों में अंतःक्षिप्त हो जाता है. ये निक्षेप सामान्यतः अनियमित आकार के भित्ति यानी डाइक अथवा सिल की आकृति में मिलते हैं. इनका अन्य चट्टानों से संबंध अंतःक्षिप्त इंजेक्टेड प्रकार का होता है. ये पूर्व निर्मित शैलकारी खनिजों पर पर्याप्त प्रभाव डालते हैं. नेक्स्ट इज इमिसिबल लिक्विड सेग्रीगेशन, अमिश्रणीय द्रव पृथक्करण. In this case, sometimes magma of an ore and silicate composition break down during cooling into two immiscible fraction in which accumulate to form liquid segregation deposits. Unmixing like oil and water in this silica and sulfate and form the sulfide mineral deposits. Lead, zinc and copper deposit of Hesatu Belwethan belt Bihar of India and nickel copper sulfide deposit in Sizwa South Africa are the best example of immiscible liquid segregation. In this immiscible liquid segregation, the sulfides and chromite are separately deposits. Hence, here there is nickel deposits. Now, immiscible liquid injection. Amishniya drava antakshepan. This immiscible liquid accumulation before consolidation when subjected to disturbances get injected into the surrounding rock forming immiscible liquid injection. A nickeliferous sulfide deposit of Sudbury, USA is an important example of this type. Also, the Singhbhum copper belt of India is an example of immiscible liquid. Here, due to the filter pressing, silicates get into the host rock of the adjacent show. The important igneous rock formed due to the residual magma is that is pegmatite, and the rock pegmatite is known as museum of minerals. These are formed towards the very end of consolidation of the magma, in which the residual fraction is highly enriched with volatile constituents. Pegmatitic liquid may be squeezed out to fill in the cracks and fissures in the parent igneous body or the adjoining country rocks and form pegmatite vein or dikes. These are usually formed between 500 to 800 degrees Celsius. The deposit of mica, feldspar, beryl, lithium minerals, gemstone and tin minerals like cassiterite are included in the pegmatite deposit. The multicolor tourmaline crystal in the Himalaya pegmatites. Also, the mica-rich pegmatites. So, this is all about the magmatic process in which we have discussed the late magmatic process. Thank you very much.